y'all. It's time. I need to hear y'all get loud. We celebrating 10 years out here tonight. Improv, this man, he comes from right here, H-Town. You've seen him crush Apollo. You've seen him on Kevin Hart's Heart of the City. You've seen him on Comedy Central. Improv, if you're here to celebrate, stand up out your feet. Get up out your chair. Get up. Get up. Get up. Make some noise for Mr. Ken. Come on, let's let him in. H-Town, I'm still as you've seen on this stage. Big round of applause for Trey the Truth, for DJ Mr. Rogers, for stepping up. Time that no one else knew how to step up, man. They stepped up and put resources together, man, and fed people and clothed people and gave people, built houses and shit, and reallocated funds, man. Get them brothers one more big round of applause. Taking care of the city that I love so much. And last big round of applause for these sexy ass pants I got on. Boy, I tell you what, the comedians ain't shit. I was in the back and I was like, nigga, those are the pants that Seeley made at the end. Niggas ain't shit. I thought I was sexy until I came up here, man. Nigga, I got pajama pants on. I told him to take them in. I don't give a fuck. This shit came with a dick print already in it. Came with another nigga dick already in it. I was like, fuck it, I'm gonna rock it, man. It's looking all right out here. I'm looking all right, man. It looks beautiful in here, all my black people, man. It's a beautiful thing. It looks like Wakanda in here. I ain't mad at you. It's Wakanda forever in here, man. For real. It's a beautiful thing. I'm glad to be home, man. I've been doing stand-up comedy for 10 years, man. Shit went by like that. I got on stage for the first time, man, in 2008. You understand me? 2008. 10 years later, man. I fucked a lot of bitches. A lot. A lot. Not a little bit. Fuck a lot. You understand? Never got an STD. I'm proud of that, man. And look, everybody got quiet like, oh, fuck you, man. Okay. I'm very glad to be home, man. This is the city I love so much, man. Love being black. I'm looking at my black people, man. Being black, I be in New York. I be moving around, man. I be seeing all different type of different people. I've been in New York 5 years now, man. 5 years. It went by like that. I've been in that 5 years. I'm still learning shit. You know, I'm still paying attention. I'm still learning shit where I'm at. One thing I learned, man, you know what I'm saying? Like, I love being black so much. I'm actually, y'all didn't notice about me, I'm actually mixed. About me. I'm actually mixed. Anybody mixed in here with something? Father? nigga everything. I don't know who I am. Actually, mixed, man. A lot of people don't know, man. It's a lot of shit that mixed people got to deal with. It's a lot of shit that you got to experience. People tease you and make fun of you. I'm actually mixed. My mother's a black woman, and my father's a nigga. So you never know which... You never know which side is going to come out, man. I like when I do the joke in front of white people. White people be looking at me like, I can't see the black, but I can see the nigga. You nose and lips. I can see that shit, man. Being black is cool, man. You know what I like? I like the setup we got. I like the broad nose. I like the full lips and shit like that. You know what I mean? Because, you know, it's a beautiful setup. White people don't have lips. I don't know if you ever noticed that or not. I don't know if you ever watched them. It's like they got nothing now. Like, no type of... There's no type of projectile, meat, skin, nothing. It's just flat, nigga. That shit, they got innies. Like, that shit is... That shit is introverted, nigga. You know, that shit is like this, like, oh. You're fired. Like, yeah, whatever, Jeff. Get you some lips, bitch. You gonna fire me? Get you some motherfucking lips, baby. It's nothing now, man. Like just look. It's like they got, like, circumcised lips or some shit like that. You ever see, like, white people, like, somebody walked up with a pair of scissors and whoosh, gone, nothing. You ever watch a movie, like, the truth hurts, she had to walk away. Comedy, the two white people start kissing. It's the most disgusting shit you ever seen in your life. You ever see that, man? It's like they're trying to figure it out for the first time. Like, y'all were like, black women walk at the house looking at the movie like, nigga, fucking gross. Like, where are they lips? How they kissing with no lips? I kissed a white woman one time, I got a paper cut on my lips. Same thing. Fuck me up, hey, bitch, goddamn. This ain't gonna work, man. I'm telling you, man. There's no lips. You ever watch a porno? Like a white chick trying to give a blowjob? Saddest shit you ever seen in your life. You can't suck if you don't have lips, man. They be on that trying, though. White women look like Bill Cosby when they be trying to suck it up. Sound different, make a different noise. It's so funny. I'm looking at the crowd, all the white guys like, what is honey, what's I don't know. They're trying to Google it. How do you spell? Siri search. The white women mad, they look at him like, I'll show him. Shit. All the husbands like, yeah, show them, honey, show them what you do. They gonna jump me after the show. Hold them down, Jeffrey. I'ma give up too. Like, yeah, you got me on this one, bitch. Touche, bitch, touche. From the north side of Houston, Texas. Anybody here from the north side? Yeah? What part? Yell it out. This nigga up here. Everywhere. Nigga made sure he was he enunciated cashmere. Cashmere Gardens over the Cashmere Gardens Elementary. From this neighborhood called Trinity Garden. Trinity Garden, born and raised. Anybody here from the south side of town? Well, nobody's perfect. Is that shit still going on, the north and south bullshit? You know what's funny? A motherfucker told me one time, he said, yeah, I used to have this chick I messed with on the south side, north side dude I know. Yeah, I have to catch a flight from Bush to Hobby just to get... Don't get no makeup on. That's real white. It's not a real brand, but the white is real though. I've had some success this year, man. Every time I come back, I've been on TV again. I don't know if y'all noticed that or not, man. This past, yeah, thanks. Had some success. I was on the show, I was on Fox. They fucked around and let me on Fox, man. Showtime at the Apollo. I was on that, man. I was on that. I didn't win. Everybody keep telling me the same shit. Man, if that white guy wouldn't know that, you would've won. And you know what? I knew it was gonna happen because I'm in the green room before the show started. And they tell me how much you win if you win the thing. It's some thousands of dollars. So I'm looking around at the competition. I was like, I'm about to kill every last one of these guys. And I'm looking at the competition, little kids, it's gimmicks. They had little kids, I was a DJ. I said, yeah, y'all cute, but I'm about to tell y'all last stuff. I keep looking, they had the dancing clowns and shit. I was like, okay, y'all not fucking me. I seen the white guy in the corner warming up his voice. Like, there's a white guy, but he was doing black people runs. Like, ooh, ooh. I say, this motherfucker. This nigga might beat me, man. So boom, we come out, they got us lined up, right? It's three of us, the top acts for the night. So this me over here, and this is, this is the white guy over here. These are dancing clowns and shit. The lady come out, all right, y'all give it up for the dancing clowns. Yeah! Here come me. Hey, y'all give it up for comedian Kim Boyle. Yeah! I say, man, I might fuck around and win this motherfucker. Y'all give it up for the singer, the guy that, yeah! I'm about to kick that nigga in the back of his teeth. The dude cheated, man, he was a pastor. Savannah, Georgia. I don't care how funny I would have been. They wouldn't go boo this nigga. And he was a white guy doing black people like Beyonce runs. Ooh, I said, man, fuck this nigga. He ain't got no pants like these. I've been learning a lot, man, up there in New York. I've been learning a lot. Another thing I noticed since I've been in New York, man, this is another thing I noticed. If you ever go to New York, look for this. So if you've been there before and you go back, try to notice this. Try to notice what I'm about to tell you. You probably never noticed it before. This is one of the first things I noticed when I first moved there. No one can walk faster than a white woman at night. You can't do it. Especially if I'm walking behind them. Something happens to a white woman at night, like their hips. It's like their hips unlock, you know? It's like this be going, but the upper body is doing this. Looking out for the danger, you know? They look like a bird or an ostrich or some shit. These motherfuckers be gone, man. They ain't trying to take no L's. Why do you think you see a lot of white women in the gym, like on the treadmill? They don't give a fuck about staying in shape. They want to make it home at night. They try not to get smashed up, man. You got to be in shape to catch a white bitch these days. Remember back in the 90s? I don't know if anybody owned it. Remember back in the 90s, man, every time you turn on the news, some white woman got kidnapped, abducted, and shit like that? Not no more. They got their shit together. No. They like Pokemon. You can't catch them all. 2018, you got to jump in a cab. Hey, man, follow that white woman over there. Come on, man, step on it. And she made enough, you lost her, man. God damn. Just take me home, man. Shit. That shit hurt your feelings, too, man. As a man, all the men know what I'm talking about. Women, you may not know exactly what I mean, right? All the men have experienced this. If you're walking somewhere late at night, you don't mean no harm to nobody. You're just walking. And some woman's walking in front of you, she turns to see you, she starts walking a little faster, hurt your feelings. She think you're a creep. You know what I'm saying? Especially as a black man, because it's a lot of unspoken shit that goes along with that. You know what I mean? It cuts you a little deeper. You walking somewhere late at night, you might have a hoodie on. You don't mean no harm to nobody, you just walking. You know what I mean? You being cool, you just walking. Some white woman in front of you, she turns to see you, she be like, gone. You be standing there with your feelings hurt, like, hey lady, that ain't cool, come on now. I'm a human being, lady, I got feelings, man. Then I turn around, see another nigga walking behind me, like, man, let me get the fuck up out of here. don't feel safe. Where am I? He be behind me. I'm a human being. Fuck you, nigga. I'm trying to make home. Tell you, man. What's up, homegirl? Everything cool? Good to see you, man. Breath still looking nice, man. Is that the time we living in? I can't give this woman a compliment on her rack or her cleavage. Is that bogus? Am I a creep if I say, hey, you got nice breasts, have a nice day, and walk off? Who said yes? Who pointed out? You right here, and you got your titties out. I gotta be honest with you, it's a lot I don't understand today. The things have changed, the rules changed, like from when I was growing up, man. It's a lot of shit I admit it, nigga, some shit I just don't know. You know, I'm in the green room in New York. I'm the only black comedian in the room. I'm surrounded by white comedians. They were trying to convince me that it's not gay for a straight man to sleep with a transgender woman. I'm the only black comedian in the room, and they try to flip little shit on you like, yo, stop being transphobic, bro. That guy's so transphobic, bro. I'm like, nigga, I ain't saying nothing. I'm scared or fuck them. They should have rights. I'm just saying, nigga, that's gay. Have the rules changed? Nigga, that's gay. Yeah, okay, so I'm the only black comedian in the room. I'm surrounded by white comedy. And they was hitting me with this pro logic. You know what I mean? So I was like, hey man, I think that's kind of gay. Not gay, bro. Post op. It's a girl now. It's a chick. Not gay. I'm repeating what they told me, D. Post op. Post operate. This nigga's so black. He like, what that mean? This nigga D looks so good. What's that? What's post? Like post on the post? That nigga in the post. He talking about like this, like the poster holding up. That's a pillar. That's definitely a pillar. Not a post. I don't know the rules, man. And I'm like, hey, that's pretty gay. But they just kept hitting me with bro logic. This is not gay, bro. Post op. Not gay. It's a chick now. Not gay, bro. Not gay, sorry bro, not gay. Not gay bro, post out, chicken up, not a dude anymore. Post out bro, not gay. Not gay bro, it said this shit like 15 times. Not gay bro, post out. Post out bro, not gay. Not gay bro, post out. Post out, not gay. So then I say, hey man, what's the procedure for turning a man into a woman, right? They take your dick and they cut it down the middle and they ram it up inside your body. Yeah, look it up, cause I did. You sleep with a transgender woman, you are putting your dick inside of another dick. Nothing could be gayer. A lot of shit I don't know, man. For real. I be trying to figure the shit out, man. One thing, I got these characteristics that's real dichotomous. It's like they contradict each other. One thing about me, I'm very OCD. Anybody OCD in here? OCD? Yeah? How so? OCD? OCD? What does your OCD look like in your life? What form does it take for you? Organization, repetition, germaphobe, what? Germaphobe. Everything gotta be clean. You gotta wash. Somebody over here. Somebody else said they was OCD. I can't remember who it was. These niggas, everybody looking down when I look at the table. I say, somebody real. They say, yeah, who was it? So who else said they was OCD?
Hey, D. I like to see footprints when I back you, but I like to see footprints.
He say, I don't like to see footprints. When I back you. You don't like to see what? Footprints. I don't like to see footprints. What we would've did, I don't like to see footprints. When I back you, right? You know these hands. Do you see footprints on the posts in your house? Boy, D-Lo, I ain't gonna lie to you, man. I used to look up to you. I used to respect you. That's my brother right there. Very OCD, man. I'm a start real simple, right? So I'm doing a show one night in New York, and my lip accidentally hit the microphone. You couldn't convince me that I didn't have AIDS. I'm talking full-blown Charlie Sheen AIDS. Now fuck that, Eazy-E AIDS. I went to brush my teeth with Clorox, it was bad. So now, okay, that's the easy. We start easy for the germs. I'm about to go a little deeper. Cause I personally think everybody got a little touch of OCD and may not even realize it. So if you see yourself in one of these situations, you got a little touch of it. So I'm gonna start, that's simple. On the microphone, I think everybody can agree with that. I'm about to get a little deeper, right? If I'm watching TV, I gotta have the volume in increments of 5. Yes. Who is you? Who else? Is it 5 or is it even numbers? Who even numbers? Even numbers? Look, you see how more people like that? Nigga, shut the fuck up. I like my volume in even numbers too. I like my volume even. You see how more people like, yeah, that's me. Everybody got this shit, man. Even guy. I gotta have even numbers, right? Now, 5, I'm sorry, I misspoke. 5, I'm a 5 guy. I gotta have 5. 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40. That's me, right? Now, here's where the shit gets contradictory. This way it gets dichotomous, right? I have a very strong will. My resolve is very strong. This is what I mean when I say this, right? Let's say if I was in the military, right? I was in the military and I got captured. I'm a prisoner of war. They trying to torture me and get government secrets out of me. I ain't saying shit. I'm built that way. I ain't talking. I wouldn't give you the satisfaction, no matter what you do to me. You can waterboard me, I ain't talking. Bust my kneecaps, cut off my eyelids, kiss my ass, I ain't telling you nothing. But put a TV in front of me and stop the volume at 17. I will lose my goddamn mind. I'm telling you everything. Hey, look, the launch code is 6969. Turn that TV up, man. I can't deal with it, man. Anybody here actually in the military, or a veteran, or used to serve in the military? Yeah? Yeah? What branch? What branch?
Navy.
Navy here? How many years?
5.
You still active, or you done?
Yeah.
Done? Get that brother a big round of applause. What about you, baby? Army. How many years? 6 years. Active or you done? Done? Get out of here, ladies. I ain't got the heart for it, man. I ain't do that for no cheap round applause. I got serious admiration. I ain't cut out for no military, man. For real. I'm about to say something. A lot of people in this room, you may not agree with it, you may not understand where I'm coming from, man. But all I need is one person, at least one person in this room, is gonna relate to what I'm about to say. This is how I knew I wouldn't cut out for no military, right? You ever do this? You ever watch a movie, like a war movie? It's a big battle scene happening. It's a lot of gunfire and explosions and shit, people dying all over the place. You ever watch a movie like that and you had this thought come to your mind like, yo, if that was me, I just lay down and play like I'm dead. I can't be the only one. Nigga, I would legit get another dead body and lay on top. Nigga, I'm gonna put mud all over my face, put some little blood, and when it's over, I'm gonna get up and go home with my lady. You ain't gonna kill me. Yeah, it'll just kill me, man. Shit, I'm gonna go home, my lady, and lie my ass off. You should have seen me out there tonight, baby. I was killing them. I'm the only one survived, man. I can't do it, man. I got a couple of ways my OCD show up. This one ain't for everybody. Everybody ain't gonna get this one. Only maybe one or two people. You ever do this? You ever walk in somebody's house for the first time? And when you walk in, you start looking around and start redecorating their house in your mind? Like, nigga, I wouldn't have put that right there. It looked better over there. Why you ain't put it over there? That's a big wall. You got a little small TV on it. You need a bigger TV. And y'all need the dust in here too. And that rug just don't match shit in here. This is the last way my OCD show up, man. When I go to the bathroom, man, I got a block. I can't shake. The fact that everybody said, what? Y'all fucking disgust me. I gotta block my dick. Does anybody not know what I'm talking about? Son, this is not how you blot your dick, bro. That nigga do this shit in his sleep. Son, if I go to the bathroom, I can't do this Neanderthal. This shit, I can't do it, baby. You get pee-pee drops everywhere. Everywhere, all over your jeans, all over the floor, all over the seat. That shit is ineffective, because when you do that, man, you got two more pee-pee drops still in your dick. If you block your dick, here's the trick. Get your little tissue, man. Damp it up. Get your thumb. Two more pee-pee drops in your drawers. Get you some tip. You got a block, man. I'm gonna show you what I'm talking about. I'm gonna prove it to you right now. Ladies in the room, make some noise. All the ladies. Now, which dick would you rather suck? Sucking PP penis all your life. Check your mail in the bathroom. Hey, nigga, you black or you shaking? Black your dick, nigga. As soon as he stepped in the bedroom, hey, let me give him a hint. Did you black or did you shake? Ziggy, you block or you block or you shake? Tell me, it's just between me and you. I ain't gonna tell nobody. That's the most guiltiest laugh I've ever seen in my life. This nigga do it. See, this is why I love being black. Cause this is like, we have a world class ability of answering a question without answering the question. Like, I can respond, but I ain't answering a motherfucking thing if I don't want to. I say, Zeke, you blotter, you shake, you. You wild. This nigga wild. Oh. You answer that way in any other setting, you are guilty than the motherfucker. You trying to hide something from me, man. I took psychology at community college. I know what I'm talking about. In any other setting, see what happens. Get pulled up by police. Get pulled up by, sir, you been drinking tonight? Ah. This nigga, wow. Sir, get out the car. You take me to jail? Ah. This nigga, wow. It's all right, man. We getting older, man. Ain't we getting older? Ain't that a bitch? That's true. I know a lot of people in here are. I don't know about you. Knock me off with this one. This one. Anybody got teenage kids in here? Y'all been fucking for a long time. How old are your teenagers? 15, 16? Ain't that a bitch? Y'all wanna feel old real quick? Wanna make you feel? Who said they had a 17-year-old? 17-year-old? You right there? That's my girl, Kiki. Okay, now check this out. Watch this. I'm gonna make you feel old. Watch this. You're 17-year-old. What year were they born in? Make you feel that old. 2001? Don't that sound funny? Don't that sound strange? Born, nigga, born in 2001. This is right after the world was supposed to end. You realize that? You know what I'm saying? Y2K, man. Does your child know about Y2K?
No.
They don't? They have no idea what it is. Remember Y2K? Everybody ran out, got spam and water, beef jerky. And they threw away all their condoms and shit. The motherfuckers are like, yo, the world gonna end. I ain't got nothing to lose. I'm going raw. How you think her child got here? You think it was love? She was a Y2K baby, man. A mad dash, a buzzer beater. You know what's funny? Anybody that's... Anybody that age, it's not fair because they got so much shit that we didn't have when we was growing up. I low-key like anybody that's under 20. Like dislike anybody that's under 20. You know why? Because they got all type of technology, man. Your 17-year-old, they got a phone? They got the internet on their phone? Come on, son. Think about it, man. Let me talk to the men just for a second. All the fellas, all the men make some noise. Just the men, all the men. All the men. Now, think about this. I want all the men to really think about what I'm about to say. Just really think about this. Give us a phone with the internet on it when we were 17 years old. Shit. You could get me in the bathroom. I cussed my mama. She, in time for school. Fuck you, bitch. I ain't going nowhere. I'm discovering myself. They can go straight to hardcore porn, man. It's not fair. We had to be dedicated when we was growing up. We had to be committed to the game. We had to stay awake to 2, 3 o'clock in the morning. Look at this nigga. For softcore porn. These niggas today don't even know what softcore porn is, man. It ain't foul. Ask the chick out Spice Channel. Anybody had Spice Channel? You remember Spice Channel? It was blurry. The picture was scrambled. You didn't know what you was jacking up to. You didn't know what you was looking at. Like, is that a titty? I think that's a titty. I think that might be a titty. Every now and then the picture would clear up. Every few minutes it'd get clear, like, oh, that's an elbow. I'm jacking off to it. Jacking off to a goddamn elbow. You didn't stop, you just realized it was an elbow. So now, as a grown man, every time I say elbow, my dick get hard as fuck. I gotta tell women before I go on dates, like, hey, you might want to put that long sleeve on before we go out. Getting old, man. Getting older. You know how I know I'm getting older, man? I don't like none of the new music that's out there. D-Lo's cool. Hig is cool. None of the new shit. I was like, these niggas sound exactly alike. I can make a trap song right now. Just right now. Because, you know, I cracked the code. All you gotta do is say the same shit over and over and over and over. If you get one line, the beat gotta be dope. You get one sentence, repeat that shit 1,000 times. You gotta hit. I'ma show you what I'm talking about. Young lady, I need a soldier. What's your name, baby? Olivia? Yeah? Y'all was late on that one, okay. I'm about to make a song right now using Olivia's name, right? Check this out. I know this chick named Olivia. I know this chick named Olivia. I know this chick named Olivia. Bitch, I know this chick named Olivia. I know this chick named Olivia. What? I know this chick named Olivia. I know this chick named Olivia. Ha! I know this chick named Olivia. I know everybody in this room is ready to buy my mixtape right now. Over and fucking over and fucking over, man. Motherfuckers don't say the year in the music no more. Niggas used to date the music. 1999 for the 9-train, it was 9-4. Am I right? Am I crazy? They niggas ain't doing that no more, man. I miss it. Fuck. And you really realize you're old. You know how you know you're old? Everybody will get this. You know you're old when everything was 10 years ago. Everybody ain't gonna get that. Everybody gonna get that. New Year's, it was 1989. Yeah, it was like 10 years ago. Nigga, no. Nigga, absolutely not. Y'all couldn't believe, man. It's a trip. I'll tell you what, man, there's a lot happening with this country. And, you know, the climate of the country, man, and the leadership that we under, man, I be finding myself in weird conversations in New York City, man. I don't want to make this a black versus white thing, but I find myself getting into a lot of debates with white guys over a lot of shit that's happening in the country right now. And a lot of things, the main thing I hear a lot from a lot of white guys is, hey, man, Trump's president, get over it. You got to get over it. It is what it is. You got to get over it. Get over it. Trump president, gotta get over it. I'm like, you gotta realize, black people don't get over shit like that, too. We still mad they replaced Aunt Viv on Fresh Prince of Bel-Air. We still got beef, man. Yeah. Some light-skinned bitch they trying to bring to me, tell me this your new heart. I don't know this bitch. I want dark-skinned Aunt Viv. I want this bitch right here. This motherfucker. Letting shit go, man. I want to tell y'all what happened to me last year. My birthday, man, my birthday is in September. I'm a September guy. And, I don't do the sign. I don't do the sign. I don't know who y'all that Virgo. I don't do the signs, man. That shit is so bogus to me. But women think it's real, though. You realize that. The only reason men do it, we try to get some pussy in the club. Y'all know that, right? Yeah, a dude comes to it. Hey, what's up, baby? I'm a Capricorn. I that my whole personality is based on the fucking date of the time of the month I was born in. I'm certain conversations I'm just too intelligent for. You can't convince me of no shit. You know what my sister said one time? This lady right over here. You wanna raise your hand so they can see who I'm talking about? No? Okay, whatever. She's married now. But when she was single, I heard her say the dumbest shit ever. You may not remember this, but I'll remember this forever for the rest of my life. She said, she's some guy she was dating. I said, yeah, how's the guy? She said, yeah, he's great, man. You know, dress nice, smart, nice job, treat me like a lady, treat me like a queen. But he's a counselor. And I don't fuck with no counselors. You got to be the dumbest bitch in the day today. American bullshit, man. You ain't never heard no woman in Africa in the bush say no shit like that. You ain't never heard no woman in Africa like, I love the Kimbe. He built fire for me. He built hut for me. He rests out lion for me. But he is Aquarius, and I don't fuck with Aquarius. Just dumb. Women on some bullshit. You know, I think a lot of women get fucked up at like romantic comedies. A lot of women look at romantic comedies like they're documentaries. Like just realize, I seen women look at romantic comedies like, see now that's the way it's supposed to be right there. He really loved her. Bitch, ain't nobody about to come running through no airport before you get on the airplane, chasing you, calling your name. Samantha! I love you! Ain't nobody about to come galloping on a horse, chasing a train. Bitch, you wanna leave? Leave! It isn't a mad look. I don't know what walk of life you follow, man, what scripture you follow. In every scripture, this is the law. This is man law. It is in a man's DNA in a relationship to do these things. Protect, provide, cultivate. That's whatever book you follow, it's in there. If I love you, I'm gonna protect you. If I love you, I'm gonna provide for you. And if I love you, I'm gonna cultivate a life and a future for us and the kids. Bitch, I don't care how long we've been together. Don't expect me to know how long we've been in. I don't give a fuck what color eyes you got. I don't care how your day was at work, bitch. The lights is on, it's food in the refrigerator. Leave me the fuck alone. I did my part. And a lot of women sleep on the protection shit. You know what I'm saying? You never got kidnapped? Bitch, I did that. Or you ain't never been raped? Me. That's me right there. If you doubt your man's love, go home, turn on light switch. If that light turns on, that man loves you. It's simple, we so simple. You know the difference, men and women? Women love small gestures of love. You know what I mean? Women will say, it's the small things that count. Men, we don't do small shit. We do big shit. How big, D? We want to come through in the clutch. We want to be the hero. They about to turn my lights out. Bitch, no they ain't. It sounds funny, but the shit is so real, man. I want to tell y'all what happened to me last year. Like I said, my birthday is in September, guy. And a good friend of mine, his birthday is 2 weeks before mine. So for his birthday, I ran out And I got some gifts. I wrapped him up, little cake and all that. So I said, man, let me run out and get some balloons. I'm gonna get my guy some balloons for presentation and all that. So as I'm leaving, I say, damn, I need some trash bags too. Get some trash bags. And right after I left, I said, you know what? Condoms. I'm fresh out of condoms. These are the three items that I need, right? So I go to the dollar store, right? I didn't win at the Apollo, nigga. I can't ball out of control like that. I go to the dollar store, a little Asian woman. She's behind her. How you doing? I said, how you doing, baby? This is a real conversation. I said, hey, let me get two of those balloons. Actually, four. You got the helium tank? You can blow it up for me? She said, yes, I do for you. I said, okay, yeah, blow it up for me. And why are you blowing it up? Do you have any condoms? She said, no, sorry, we don't carry the condom here. I said, it's cool, baby. You got any trash bags? Her whole accent up, nigga, trash bag. What type of dick you got? You need a trash bag. Body surgery, that shit is so disgusting. Be yourself, be who you are, man. Woman's body is so beautiful, man. This is doing extra shit online. Her legs this big, ass coming all the way out of this guy. Thank you, she's fine. Yeah. Baby, you like a goddamn fool. Man, we ought to start doing that, man. We gotta compete.
No.
Shut up, this is my show. You were saying no when I was saying your light bill, dude, and I'm coming through, like, yeah, that sound right, right there. We need to compete with this foolishness. We need to go to my Dr. Miami and walk in the bedroom like this, like, yeah, what's happening? Wait till this motherfucker get hard, I'm gonna show you something. So my boy's birthday is done, and now it's time for my birthday, right? So my birthday fell on a Saturday. He said, hey man, look, Saturday comes, be ready, 10 a.m. I'm gonna pick you up, got a surprise for you. I said, bet. 10 a.m., Saturday comes, I get up, I get ready, he put me in the car, we drive. We drive for like an hour, right? We rolling. We get to Long Island over in New York. Pull up to this building. He says, yo, bro, check this out, happy birthday, man, I set this up for you. The builder says, Long Island skydiving, right? I said, hey, man, look. I just woke up, nigga. I ain't ready for no shit. And what type of gift is this? Like, surprise, nigga, you might die today. Happy birthday. Anybody ever been skydiving before you? Anybody skydiving? Skydiving? Right here? You right there? You right there. Now watch this. You can be my panel. You, right? If I say anything that's not true, you stop me. If I say anything that you didn't experience, you yell out, you stop me. I'll stop on the spot. This is the way it works. You walk in. There's literally a Bible of paperwork you need to sign off on, right? You're literally signing your life away. The shit says, I acknowledge that I can sustain permanent damage and possible death if I get on this airplane. The lady says, sir, can you sign? I say, bitch, I'm not signing that. Kiss my ass. Fuck you, lady, I ain't signing that. She says, sir, if you don't sign, you can't get on the plane. I say, cool, I fuck around and sign. Here's the cold part. This way I get cold. She pulls out a video camera, right? She says, sir, I need you to look in this camera and repeat everything you just said. Am I lying? She say, look in this camera and repeat everything. My name is Ken Boy, and I acknowledge if I get on this plane, I can sustain permanent damage and possible death. She say, thank you, that's all I need. I say, bitch, how do you sleep at night? How do you look yourself in the mirror, bitch? So boom, now I don't know if y'all know this, you tethered, you connected to another guy the whole time. This is you, wherever he goes, you go. Like this is you, and I'm the other guy, and you strapped on to another dude. Just like this, if he sneezes, hit you. Hey, nigga, come on. Am I lying? Am I lying? Where's my other girl? Where's my other? Am I lying? Am I lying? You strap to another guy, right? Wherever he go, you go. In order to do the harness, the dude to sit down. The dude to sit down. He said, hey bro, we gotta adjust the harness. I need you to sit on my lap. Need you to sit on my lap so I can adjust the harness. I say, yeah. Yeah, we can do that standing up, can't we? You can't convince me we can't do this shit standing up. Say, come on, bro, this is serious. Come on, I need you to sit on my lap so I can tighten the heart. So, man, I'm a grown nigga sitting on this nigga's lap. So he tightened the harness. He's pulling the straps and shit, but my body is doing weird shit while he's jumping. I say, bro, is that tight? I say, yeah, that's tight. You good? I say, yeah, I'm good. I'm just not used to sitting on a nigga's lap. Asking me, is it tight? He said, all right, man, this is important, man. Now we got the harness on. When we start falling out this plane, I need you to arch your back. Am I making it up, baby? Sharon, am I making it up? He said, I need you to arch your back like a banana. I need you to arch your back like a banana. I said, nigga, can you pick another fruit, please? Gotta be something. How come it can't be like a boat? How can I can't arch like a boat? This is serious, bro. Arch your back like a banana. So I backed his ass up on him. He said, man, is that tight? Yeah, that's tight. He goes, second part, man. When we falling, I need your neck to be secure. I need you to lean your head on my shoulder, just like this. Your neck gotta be secure. Lean your head on my shoulder while you're arching your back. Here go the last part. I need you to tuck your legs back too. I'ma have my legs out, have your legs in, my leg, have your leg tucked back. I'm a grown nigga sitting on this nigga's lap with my back arched and my head laying on his shoulder with my legs tucked back. This is the worst birthday gift ever. So now, we're in the app at this point. We up, right? The man say, hey bro, when I open this plane, this is how it's gonna go. I'm gonna take my left leg, hang it out the plane, and when I do that, you take both of your legs and you hang them out the plane. So in my mind, it's gonna be some type of countdown. One, two, three, 3, 2, 1, 10, 9, 8, nigga, something. Right? We up in the air, the door opens. He said, all right, bro, the door's open. Put his leg out. He said, all right, bro, my leg is out, you ready? I say, man, yeah, just let me know whenever you ready. I'm calling this nigga every name in the book. You bitch ass motherfucker. But the whole time, I had my back arched and my head moving on the nigga's shoulder. Man, I love y'all so much, man. Thank you. Thank y'all, man. Goddamn, man. Thank y'all, man. 10 years, man. lift this next person to the stage. I need some help bringing them up. We have author, philanthropist, just overall social amazing guy, and he's also the producer of this show. Y'all give it up for Mr. Carlos Wallace one time. Mr. Soul Caribbean himself.
We normally do this at the end, but Trey has to go. He told me he had a performance tonight, so we're gonna go ahead and honor him before he leaves. Mr. Trey, come on up, man. It's just a small something to say thank you for all the work you do in the community, for Harvey, for Trader Truth, for how many years, Trader, like 5, 6, 7, 10 years, how many years in a row, man, just for everything you do, from Soul Creators, the whole Soul family, and all of us. Just thank you, brother.
Honest, I ain't necessarily know what I was coming up before. I just told Ken we was coming to support him, man. So shout out to y'all for even taking the time to think about us, and really not even just us, the city of Houston, because it's always me, my partner, Mr. Rogers, the whole relief gang. At the end of the day, we still trying to rebuild Houston one day at a time, you know what I'm saying? So it's going down, and you mentioned Trey Day coming up next month, so it's gonna be real big this year. H-Town, you know we love y'all, man.
You go. In order to do the harness, the dude to sit down. He said, hey bro, we gotta adjust the harness. I need you to sit on my lap. So I can adjust the harness. I say, yeah. Yeah, we can do that standing up, can't we? You can't convince me we can't do this shit standing up. Say, come on, bro, this is serious. Come on, I need you to sit on my lap so I can tighten the harness. So, man, I'm a grown nigga sitting on this nigga's lap. So he tightened the harness. He's pulling the straps and shit, but my body is doing weird shit while he's jumping. I say, yeah, that's tight. You good? I say, yeah, I'm good. I'm just not used to sitting on a nigga's lap. Asking me, is it tight? But I'm good though. He said, all right, man, this is important, man. Now we got the harness on. When we start falling out this plane, I need you to arch your back. Sharon, am I making it up? He said, I need you to arch your back like a banana. I said, nigga, can you pick another fruit, please?